This ELISA tutorial series is kindly sponsored by CalBiotech. Please click the link below or in the video description to see what ELISA kits they have to offer. Finishing the assay. In this video, we are going to perform the final steps of an ELISA. Our detailed ELISA protocol can be found on the website, which is linked in the video description. At this point, you have added your samples to the ELISA plate and have incubated them for 2 hours at room temperature or overnight in the refrigerator. Now, you will want to prepare the detection antibody by diluting the correct amount of it in 10 milliliters of reagent dilutant. Once the diluted detection antibody is ready, empty out and wash the ELISA plate 3 times with 200 microliters of wash buffer, as described before in our earlier ELISA tutorial video. The washing step is important because it removes any unbound sample protein from the wells of the ELISA plate. After finishing the wash steps, add 100 microliters of detection antibody to each well of the ELISA plate. Cover the plate as before and incubate it again for either 2 hours at room temperature or overnight in the refrigerator. During this incubation step, the detection antibodies will bind to the sample proteins that have been captured by the capture antibody. As a side note, it's important to prepare your reagents before doing the washes, instead of the other way around. This will help prevent the ELISA plate from drying out between steps, which could be harmful to the samples. Another thing to keep in mind is that from this point forward, the long incubation times are over and the assay is almost done, so be sure that your plate reader will be available for you in about 40 minutes to 1 hour. After the detection antibodies have been incubated, prepare the Strep HRP by diluting it in reagent dilutant. For this kit, 50 microliters of Strep HRP are to be diluted in 10 milliliters of reagent dilutant. Some ELISA protocols may not use Strep HRP because the enzyme which produces a color change is already bound to the detection antibody. This kit works a little differently, however. Here, the detection antibody has a protein called biotin attached to it. Biotin binds very strongly with another protein called streptavidin, or strep for short. In this ELISA kit, strep is connected to HRP, which is the enzyme that produces a color change. Therefore, we have to perform one extra step to get the HRP enzyme connected to our detection antibody in order for us to measure our protein of interest. Once the strep HRP has been diluted, wash the ELISA plate 3 times in order to remove any unbound detection antibody from the wells. After washing, add 100 microliters of the strep HRP to each well of the ELISA plate. Incubate this time for only 20 minutes at room temperature and be sure to protect the plate from light. This can be accomplished by covering the plate with some aluminum foil or a cardboard box. A few minutes before the 20-minute incubation is complete, prepare the substrate solution. For this protocol, you can simply combine 5 milliliters of color reagent A with 5 milliliters of color reagent B. Once the 20-minute incubation time is over, wash the ELISA plate 3 times in order to remove any unbound strep HRP. Add 100 microliters of the substrate solution to each well of the plate. Incubate the plate for 20 minutes at room temperature and protect the plate from light. During the incubation period, bring the ELISA plate next to the plate reader along with the stop solution and pipetting equipment. Be careful when handling the stop solution because it is a very strong acid. Transfer 5 milliliters of stop solution to the reservoir and set your multi-channel pipetter to 50 microliters. Program the plate reader to read absorbance at the wavelength indicated by the manufacturer. That would be 450 nanometers for this kit. The samples should be turning blue at a rate which reflects the amount of protein of interest. If you have prepared a standard curve, the best time to stop the reaction with stop solution is when the most diluted sample in your standard curve has produced a little bit of blue color. When the plate is ready, add 50 microliters of stop solution to each well of the ELISA plate. The blue color should immediately change to yellow as shown here. As with the blue color, darker yellow indicates more of the protein of interest than lighter yellow. Read absorbance in the plate reader as soon as possible, and congratulate yourself for finishing the ELISA. Thanks for watching.